Good morning and hello everyone, and welcome to CTL's Education Professional Development Series. My name is Amy Al-Khaleesi, EdTech Project Manager here at CTL, and I am joined by Stephanie Shea, our Marketing Manager. For those of you who are not familiar with CTL, we are headquartered in Portland, Oregon, and have been providing innovative IT solutions to education and government customers for over 26 years. We are a Google for Education partner, and some of our most popular products include our brands of ruggedized CTL, Intego PC laptops, convertibles, 2-in-1s, and tablets designed specifically for K-12 education. Over the last 2.5 years, we've worked with Google to introduce a line of CTL Chromebooks that have been recommended by PC Magazine as the best choice for Chromebooks in education. As part of our commitment to education, CTL is offering monthly professional development webinars for education customers. These webinars will include a variety of topics relevant to K-12 ed tech, but will have a big focus on Google Apps for Education and Chromebooks in the classroom. Today's webinar is an introduction to WeVideo, presented by Eric Peterson, who has just retired from a 32-year career in teaching math and computers at the middle school level to pursue his passion of video production. However, before we get started, I'd like to go over a few items so you know how to participate in today's event. We've taken a screenshot of an example of attendee interface. You should see something that looks like this on your own computer desktop in the upper right-hand corner. You are listening in using your computer speaker system by default. If you would prefer to join over the phone, just select telephone in the audio pane and the dial-in information will be displayed. You will have an opportunity to submit text questions to today's presenter by typing your questions into the questions pane of the control panel. You may send in your questions at any time during the presentation. We will collect these and address them during the question answer session at the end of the presentation. If we run out of time, you will be contacted by your sales representative to make sure all your questions are answered. But before we begin, I'd like to take a poll to learn more about our attendees today. Please indicate if you have ever used WeVideo. We will take a moment to give you a chance to fill out the poll. So let me come over here and launch this. I'm going to make sure everybody can see that. Okay, if I can share our results here. Did you guys see the share results? I think so. It says yeah. 50% no experience, 0% some experience, 50% a lot of experience. So it looks like we're half and half and no one's an expert. So, except for our presenter. All right, so hopefully that is hidden and it's off your screen. All right, let's see. Before I turn it over to Eric for a presentation, I'd like to remind everyone about some resources for our Nevada 21 educators. When you visit the nr21.ctl.net website, you can learn about upcoming professional learning opportunities. Sign up for updates about upcoming events and information. And we also have a Google Plus private community for Nevada 21 educators as well. And now I'd like to introduce Eric Peterson, who has just retired from a 32-year career in teaching, the last 30 in Nacoosa, Wisconsin, teaching math and computers at the middle school to pursue his passion of video production. He now spends most of his time doing sports highlight videos and helping teachers integrate video production into their classroom. In this session, you will come away with an activity you can do with your students to introduce them to video production and WeVideo, and also learn how to set up your education account. That's super exciting. So I'm going to now change over. There'll be a little delay to Eric Peterson's screen. All right, Eric, take her away.
Can you see my screen and hear me?
Should be coming up.
I can hear you. This is Stephanie.
Okay.
But yeah,
Oh,
it just
okay.
takes a moment for the screen to pop up.
That's okay. I can start. Hello. And yeah, as you heard, I just retired from teaching. So so hang in there, teachers. There's light at the end of the tunnel. It's been very interesting, but that's not why we're here today. We're here to talk about video production, WeVideo production. And
Eric, I'm not sure we can see your screen yet.
Oh, okay. That's okay. I don't have anything on the screen yet.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I just have my main slide, so I won't. Let me know when the screen comes up.
Eric, do you get a notice that said allow screen sharing?
Yeah, so put your screen up if you can, or the slide. There you go. Perfect. Okay.
Oh, you can see it now? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, here we go. So anyway, I guess all the years that I've been to different, when I've gone to professional development, my hope is that when I come away from that, that I have an activity or something. I don't want to get, you know, 50 ideas. I want to get one or two good ideas that I can use in my classroom. So that's my thought. So I guess the goal today is that you can do an assignment, a project that you can learn WeVideo production, and then the same assignment project that I'm going to show you today, you can do it yourself, and you can also use it with your students. And I see some of you that have no experience. It looks like half of you have no experience. Some have a lot of experience. Those of you that have no experience, I would suggest that you actually do this. And those of you that had a lot of experience, this is a good introductory with students. And then I will talk a little bit about the setup of WeVideo. Okay. So my background in video editing, as you heard, my passion, you know, the sports highlights. That's kind of how I got into it. But in school, then I taught sixth grade. I was on a team of five, and I taught math. And then I had one computer class, and then there was four other teachers, you know, social studies, science, reading, language arts, that I worked with. So I was able to integrate a lot of video into their classrooms, you know, just with, you know, we would start, like, in reading class, book trailers. And that was a good introduction. And we did this using iMovie a long time ago, you know, where the reading teacher would do the storyboard, but then they'd bring it into my computer class, and I would teach them that part of it. And we did the same thing in science with weather forecasts using green screen, and then doing something where kids had to show Newton's laws, you know, the three different, you know, show how they work. And then math, you know, with me being the math teacher, you know, that was easy. But again, we would do some stuff in the math class, you know, taste test commercials or show how to understand fractions, make a video showing that, and then, you know, and then finish it up in computer class. So I did that for many years, and, you know, and like anything else, you get better the more you do it. But for the most part, it was just kind of, I just gave a camera in here, you know, go film it. We spent more time on the planning part and the video editing part. And, you know, and some of those videos, you know, they're kids, so they're kind of hard to watch. They're not real exciting, I guess, you know. But as we know in most projects, the learning happens long before you push the play button. You know, the preparation for showing how to understand fractions, you know, before they finish their video, whether it's a good video to a fun video to watch or not, they learned a lot throughout the process, you know, and that's the goal. But so things changed for me about 4 or 5 years ago. We're down spring break, rainy day in a mall, in a bookstore, and then I came across a book, and the title just jumped out at me, How to Shoot Video That Doesn't Suck. You know, and then I started reading it in there, and I had to buy it right away. And then I was kind of, you know, thinking back of all the videos that I watched as a teacher from kids, and it's like, oh man, I wish I would have had this 20 years ago. So kind of my goal today is to, you know, take you so you can not go through that same part that I did in, you know, the first 20 years where, you know, I was able to look at a lot of other things about video, not just video editing, but video production and starting with a camera. So what I did was I thought of this project right away, and this idea I got out of the book. You don't have to go buy the book. You can Google it, and the guy, Steve Stockman, I think his name is, he has a good website you can look at and get ideas from there. What I did was I kept thinking on spring break. I'm thinking, okay, 2 weeks after spring break in sixth grade, we had this big activity at the end of the day on Friday where kids go to one room and they're playing chess, they're playing Farkle, playing, like they're doing three-dimensional drawing, you know, a number of things. And so we all got them together, told them what they're doing, and then we sent them on their separate ways. And I grabbed two kids, two boys I grabbed. I said, okay, you guys just volunteered to take some video for me. And they've done video editing before, but so I gave them each a camera, and I said, okay, you guys are going to take video, and we're going to bring the video into computer class, and we're just going to put it in. This is back when we were using iMovie way back, or I don't know, 5-6 years ago, and they were just, and I said, I'm just going to put the video in and add a song to it. I'm not going to cut anything. I'm not going to edit. So I said, it's your job to try to make it look entertaining. You know, so you're going to take video, and that video that you take is all going to go into this. And it's going to be like a 3-minute song. Okay, so you try to make it entertaining. So Gary, one of the boys, I said, okay, you go in the science room and you can start filming in there. And Fred, you stay put, you stay in here. So I sent Gary off. And then Fred, I said, hey, Fred, I'm going to tell you three things, okay? And so what I want you to think of is I want you to look for, I'm going to show you parts of these videos that I made, and I want you to try to think of what three things did I tell Fred, okay? So here I want to get sound, so I'm going to unplug my headset here, so you're going to have to make sure that you can hear me when this is all said and done. So this video, and again, I did not tell Gary anything at all, except that, you know, I want it to be an exciting, you know, try to make an exciting video. Actually, when Gary did this, he had about 15 minutes worth, so I did have to cut a lot out of his. I'm not going to show you this whole 3 minutes. And you can see he keeps it on here for another probably 40 seconds. And that's about all I can watch. Now let's take a look at Fred. Now again, now think of Fred. I told him three things. What three things did I tell him?
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down some familiar road, and although this way just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll be
okay, I think you get the picture. So what three things did I tell him? And this is where... Okay, can you hear me? Let's see.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. I just want to get through my my microphone again. So you can hear me okay?
Yep.
Okay, good. So what three things did I tell him? And And when I ask this of the students and even teachers when I do this with them, they all get it right away. The very first thing, hold the camera still. You know, treat it like a still, like you're, you know, taking a photo. And you saw that first one with Gary, that camera's all over the place. Now, that's just hard to watch. Different angles. Fred did a nice job of that. You know, he shot straight on angles, got up high. If I'd have kept playing, he got on the floor, got some, you know, looking up, zoomed in on the chess pieces of the background, you know, and just made it more fun to watch. And then the last thing I said was short shots, okay? And that's my question to you. And that's the other thing I'll ask kids at this point, how short is short? What do you think I told them? And when I ask kids this, and even adults, they all say, oh, it's about 5, 10, 15 seconds. Some will even say 30 seconds or whatever. But, you know, how short were they? And let's just count them. You know, here, 1,001, 1,002, 1,001, 1,002, 1,001, 1,002, 1,001, 1,000, yeah, so they're short. I told him 2 seconds, you know, turn it off. And if you watch TV or if you watch highlight films or if you watch anything like that, just you'll be amazed how short the shots are sometimes. You know, that if you watch like a movie trailer, a lot of them sometimes are under 1 second. You know, so from this, the assignment and your project is, and I did this with kids, to create an awesome video. That's what we call them, awesome videos. So you're going to work with a partner, and each person is going to do everything. And the goal is to make an ordinary activity watchable. So say I'm going to work with Fred, Fred's going to do something ordinary, like reading a book, tying a shoe, typing on a computer, writing on a piece of paper, writing on the board, or something. So, but it's my job, not Fred's job. I'm going to do Fred, you know, reading a book. So, it's my job to make it watchable. You know, so how do I do that? Okay, these three things: hold the camera still, different angles, you know, and keep the shot short. What I'm going to say is to try to shoot for 20 different angles and keep them short, keep them really short, okay? But get creative. You know, zoom in on the eyes reading, zoom in on the words of the book, the cover of the book, get the cover with the eyes looking at it, get up high, down low, from the side, get over the shoulder shot. You know, just get creative, and that's how you can make interesting video. Okay, even with something ordinary like this. So this first assignment project, you're going to, you know, everybody will shoot, everybody will upload, organize, cut or trim or split the clips. You're going to add a title, add music, fade in, fade out, and then publish it. Okay, so that's, yeah, I'm going to take you through this project right now, just show you how to do it. My suggestion is that, especially if you're a beginner, this is a great way to start. But this is a good first project with kids to understand the whole process. And most of what we do here, you know, 90% of video production is all of this right here, all this right here, nothing more. You know, you don't need any fancy, you know, and I'll show you some of the fancy stuff too, which you can have a lot of fun with. But this is the biggest part right here. And what you need to think of is, you know, cameras and uploading media. You know, that you have Chromebooks that have, you know, the 180-degree cameras on them. So you may want to use just the Chromebooks for it. So, and that's easy because then you can just take the video right inside of WeVideo. We had little flip cameras that we used, you know, and then just to be able to upload the media, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you to the WeVideo editor, and I just want to show you quick. There's three other pages, but you're not going to see these pages now. I'll make these slides. This is what we're going to do, okay? But actually, we're going to spend most time in the editor, and just so you can see how WeVideo works, being this will be new for many of you, okay? So I'm going to head over here to WeVideo, and let's make this a little bigger. So, you know, you just go to WeVideo.com, okay, and you can have a link or, you know, type it in. And then for kids, you're going to hit login to start. And WeVideo is real nice because it works well with Google, so I'm just going to log in with Google. And I got a bunch of accounts on my computer, so I'm going to use that one. And now this is the WeVideo editor right here. I know this is the home page, and you're going to see, you know, this home page here is recent edits. And then you got projects, media, videos. I'm going to be going through all of these a little bit. And notice the upload, the upload right here. You can upload just about anywhere, okay? I'm not going to do it just yet. But so we're going to go into projects. And when you go into projects, this will be empty. Okay, but a project is where you start. You know, inside your project, you have different. You can have different videos that you're creating. And right now, so I'm just going to go to create new project, and then I'm going to give a name, just AV for awesome videos. Now, this is the part that you kind of need to understand. I mean, this is, to me, what sets WeVideo apart from all other video editors. We're going to do a personal one right here because the goal is for everybody to do everything, okay? But later on, a collaborative project, you know, I mentioned the Newton's Laws video in science, so that was collaborative. So say three people are working together and they videotape something, they upload it, and they create a collaborative project. All three of them can access, you know, that media that they videotaped. And let's say in class they start, you know, working, and Fred over here has, you know, is logged in. So the three of them are working on Fred's computer. They start building his timeline. And then class ends, you know, it gets saved. And then later on, Gary over here in study hall, he opens up that same project, and he can continue working on that same same timeline that they worked, you know, so they can all work, they can't work on it together at the same time, but they all have access to it, and nobody else does. As a teacher, you will, but no other students will. So that's collaborative. Shared projects, we had a lot of fun with that, you know, like last year in sixth grade, we always take the kids downhill ski. Yeah, we have snow in Wisconsin, and you know, a fun trip for us, we take them downhill skiing, they go tubing, and I don't want kids videotaping, so I do all the videotaping, that they have all the fun. But then what I can do then is I put it in a shared, it's a shared project, so, and I just share it with all the sixth grade kids, so they can each make their own highlight video from that. But this person here cannot see what they are doing, they cannot access their timeline. That's the collaborative part. Share just means we're sharing the media that all the kids can access and they can work on their own. And that's a really good function too. So this to me is the best part of WeVideo. It's truly a we part of the video. So then the next part is to add media. Now you're not going to have any media to add, so I'm not going to add any in mine. And I'll show you how to do that. So now I'm going to create the video, and now we're going to the editor, okay? In the editor, there's two different ways you can do editing, or you know, there's two different modes to it, I guess. And right up here, this is what I call the, it's the main menu, I guess I always call it the file menu, because I think of the, you know, the file as in up here. You know, but in here, in the main menu, there's something called storyboard mode and timeline mode. My suggestion, most of you, from what I understand, are middle school teachers, is to stay in this timeline mode. But you may see some kids here sometime, and they're going to ask, hey, how come mine looks a lot different than yours? And you notice how there's no tracks here. You know, this is here. It's just a real different look. And this is, if you're going to do editing with maybe first grade or second grade or something like that, this may not be a bad place to start because it's real simple. You just simply drag and drop them in here. But again, there's not a lot of other things you can do with it. So I would suggest staying away from that and just go right into the timeline mode, okay? Let me get rid of that. So now here's our world. First, we've got to upload, okay? And I'm going to do that here. So I click upload, and now, if you have a device to hook up to a computer, if you have a device to hook up, you can do it here. Just browse to select, and you know, and then you you know, on a Mac, you're going to find that the device is here. Okay, most of you, you know, and this is what you got to figure out with your Chromebooks, especially if you're going to video with your Chromebooks. It's going to go right into WeVideo, so you don't have to worry about that. But if you get it into your Google Drive, that's a real easy place to download from. So for me, I have a bunch of, I've got some videos in here. You just simply click on it, hit select, and it's going to ask where do you want it. It's going to go in my media folder. I got a bunch of other folders there, but I'll just put it in there. And then now it's going to upload, and there it is. You know. If you are going to use your this to videotape, you can do it right here. Hit record, and you can do screencasting, which is awesome, and or you can use it as a webcam. Okay, and then you hit continue, and then now you're gonna see me. Hi. So I just hit record. 3, 2, 1. Stop recording, and there it is. I want to save it or download. If I just hit save, it's going to upload there, and then it's going to show up in my media, okay? And I'm not going to go for that, but I just want to show you how it's done. I mean, that's how you would record using your Chromebook, okay? So now, what I want to do is to show you how to get the media, you know, how to build your video. So right now, here's your main video track, okay? And for me, all the ones I didn't have a partner to work with to do my awesome video, so I just used my dog, Timber. So I took a bunch of different shots of him. They're all about 3 to 5 seconds long. So when you build your video right now, you just simply click and drag them in here, okay? And notice how when I put my mouse over and see the 319 right there. That means that clip is 3 seconds and 19 frames. There's 30 frames in a second, so this is a little over 3.5. Okay, and I click another one here, and then put it over here. But you see how I can't see the whole timeline. So what you're going to want to do is get used to this thing down here. Okay, where you can zoom out, you can pull and drag it. Okay, and you know, that's good because you want to be able to see the whole timeline, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you another way to do it. To get it off the timeline, you can drop it here, delete it from the timeline. It doesn't delete it from here. It just deletes it from my timeline. You can click on it. You can hit the little trash can here. I can hit the delete on my keyboard, and then it's gone, okay? But here's another way to put – I want to put them all in here at once. I can click here, you know, to select them all like that. You know, that's do it, or you can do something like this where you just click and drag and see how they're all being checked. So now that's a real quick way to put them all into your timeline. Okay, now I got them all in the timeline, but again, I cannot see the end of it, so I can adjust this, but there's a shortcut here. When you kind of mouse over, do you see where it says you can double click to fit to width? So if I double click on this, now I see the beginning and the end of it. It makes my timeline just the perfect size so I can see the whole thing. Okay, now here's where you're going to want to, again, I want to make about a 15 to 20 second video, okay, and I'm not going to do the whole thing here. I got another version of it, but I want to show you how to edit and how to trim the clips. So again, that's a 3 second clip here. Now when we do the editing, I'm going to zoom in a little bit, okay? It's kind of nice to work with it like this. Couple ways you can trim clips. Now I'm not going to worry too much about what it looks like, but you can, you know, click and drag through to see it. So I'm just going to go to the end here, see how it's highlighted, and I'm going to get it down to like 1 second. Okay, we'll keep our clips at about 1 second, and do that. So that's one way you can trim. Another way you can trim clips is up here. Where you go up to this part here and pull it, and you see on my timeline how it's getting shorter. I can trim the front of it there. I can trim the end of it here and get it about the, you know, get it about a second. I personally, I don't use that. I always do it down here. Another way you can do it, let's say I got a clip that I want to split. Like here's one here. It's got some bad footage in front, so you got to split it. So right there, I want to split at that spot. See this up here, that little scissors? I can click on that, and I just split the clip. This part here is bad, so I make sure it's selected. I hit the delete, and then I can split the end here, or I can, again, I can trim at the end and see how it's showing bad video all the way up to the shot that I want, and that's a different shot, you know, again, a different shot of it. So that's one way to do it. Now I'm going to get it all here. Now let's say there's a clip that there's a, like, let's say I really like this clip. Another thing you can do on this is I can split it like this and then move it over here. See how to move the order of it, I can split, split, and then just drag it. And that's how you move the order of it. Okay, so now, you know, so again, when you do yours, to just mess around in this timeline is a good thing. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to, you know, and at some point you should probably save it. You know, you can just save it by clicking up here to rename it, or you can go here and hit save, and it'll ask you to name it. I'm going to go back to projects and pull out another one. I don't really want to save that. I've got here in Awesome Videos, just Timber. So this is going to be the kind of the same thing, but it's, you know, see how I got it down to 17 seconds. I didn't want to go through that whole thing with you. I just want to give you an idea. So what I want to do is add a title. Okay, so up here, this is where all the media is, and you know, these other things I'll show you in a little bit, but here's where you can add a title. Okay, so I'm going to go to text, and I'm just going to click and drag, and then put that, and see the title would be in between those two clips I want in the beginning, so you can see how it's right there in the beginning of it. That title is way too long. It's an 8-second title, so I'm going to pull it down to 2, and then to change. Now I'm going to edit this. You know, here we're editing the timeline. If I want to edit a clip, I can click right here on that. You see it says edit selected clip. I can click on that, or I can just double click. And then it takes me up here to the editing mode where I'm editing that clip. So here I'm just going to call it, you know, the name of it is Timber. You can change the font and all this stuff. You can change the size right here. Real easy to work with. I'm done editing. You know, and then it goes all the way. You know, so what I did, if you're really into something like this, a lot of times to do a video, you want to start with a close-up, and then to end a video like this, you want to start with a kind of a faraway shot that fades out, okay? So the other thing we want to do is add sound, a song. Whoops, there's the sound. And clear inspiration, we're going to do that one. And so now I want to get this. The song is a lot longer than what I have there, as you can see, because it's 18 seconds. So I'm gonna just pull the sound way down, okay, and then go back here, okay, and close it. Get it right here. So now what we want to do is we want to fade out. There's a couple ways you can fade out. And like most editing, there's a couple ways you can do everything, but now I'll do the audio, and there's two ways to do it. One way is to show levels like this, where you can, you know, this is the level of the music right here, so I'm going to put a little point in it right there, and then at the very end, I'm going to pull it down, okay? And then now that shows it, you know, fading out. Okay, and then I can do the same in the beginning. Oh, I didn't have it all the way there, so that's going to change this a little bit. But I can just go here, and then you can drag these clips too. You can move it over here, and that's how, again, that's how easy it is to work with. So that's how that was, and then we can fade in the music too if we want, by pulling that. Okay, the other thing we want to do is we want to fade out, you know, we just want to fade out. So we don't want to just, you know, play this and just have the end of it like that. We want to make it look professional, okay? So up here in the main, we can, and this is where we're going to add the audio track, or there is audio to this video. So if I click on this, now you can see the audio for this. So I could actually change the audio in each one of those, which I don't want any audio in there. I'm going to click show levels here, and notice how I can see the levels of both. So I could change it here, but I don't, the easiest way is to go right here. I'm going to kind of mute that whole track. Now there's no sound coming out of the main video track. All the sound will just be from the audio. And I want to get, and I just want to hide this again so it's not, you know, it's not too confusing. But now to fade out, I can put points up here. This is called opacity points. So I'm going to click, oh, I missed it. And you just pull this down. You see how the opacity right here is going to go down? So when I click, and then the music fades out at the same time. And then you can do the same thing in the front over here where you just click, oh, I missed it again. And, you know, so now it's going to fade in. Okay, so now we're ready to play. Okay, now we're ready to play it. So you can see the fade in, the opacity will fade in, that fades in, and this here. So now we're ready to play it. So I'm gonna unplug it so you can hear it. After this, we're going to finish. It's going to fade out. And it looks a little more professional that way. Now, can you hear me?
Yes.
Through my microphone, you can hear?
Yes.
Oh, okay, good. I wasn't sure if I had to go through. So anyway, that's, now we just created our short video, and now we're going to this allows you to watch it, you know, full screen. It allows you to put it somewhere. It will automatically publish to WeVideo. If you want to go to Drive, and in the setups, you know, like you can, if you want kids to be able to go to YouTube, these other ones, I'll show you that in the admin later, but this is where you will finish it, and then you just click here, and now it's publishing it, okay, and where it's going to go here into videos, okay, and you can see I've practiced this a little bit, so this is where the videos are. And as an administrator, I can see all the videos, not just mine. You know, here's some kids working on green screen stuff. But then the cool part is you can put like those into a gallery. You can put them into a gallery, and let's say you have all those awesome videos from your class. You can put them all in the same, you know, you put a, there's a playlist, awesome videos, we'll call it AV, next, and then you just click all the videos you want in that playlist, and then you can play them from there. So this is a good place to play, or we also publish to Google Drive. So another place, you know, like we always put them, we had a Google site for our classroom, so we put them there. Kids would embed them there, Google Classroom you could do, all kinds of options. Now, there's probably a good time to, it looks like it's, you know, this is a notification that it's ready. But the other thing, before I get into some other projects, well, let me just start one here. We'll go into the effects one. I'm going to show you some of the things WeVideo can do. But for all these things here that, one of the things I want to show you is the help. WeVideo has awesome help and support. They really do. So if there's anything, if you just click on this, the help videos come up right away, and they will show you this year takes you to the WeVideo Academy, and there's all kinds of stuff, you know, the basics, but the part I really like is these are really short and to the point. You know, if you want to learn more about storyboard, but here's WeVideo for education. If you need to learn more about the basic account setups, there are short, they're 2-minute videos, usually anywhere from 1 to 2 minutes, but the basic editing, what I just showed you, there's a whole bunch right here. I'm going to show you some of the advanced editing right now, and they're all here. Screen recorder tool is good, you know, adjusting the levels. There's all kinds of stuff, you know, so that's, and they got some great help here. And the other place you can go is here, the support center. And there you can, they have, you know, the questions, you can do that. There's also a place to email. There's a link there you can email WeVideo with questions. So now what I want to show you is a little bit more about some of the advanced features, okay? And, you know, so we've been working mainly, we're all on the main timeline here, okay? And what I want to show you is how these other timeline works. Like, you know, if you have one right here. So let's say I put something in the timeline above it. And this is some clips I got because I want to show the green screen here. And here's where you can preview it. So I got Chuck walking in front of a green screen. So when you play here, when I play this video, it plays from the top down. So when it gets to this part, you're going to see the green screen. You're not going to see Timber. So this part here, you're going to see the dog. Oh, I guess I already have that. Let me undo that. Done editing. So let me show you that again. You know, so you're going to see that. So the goal of the green screen is to key out, get rid of this green. That's how it works. So you just get rid of one color, and then you will see what's underneath that. So we'll still see Chuck because he's not green, but in this part here, we're going to see what's underneath it. So that's how that's how color keying works. So if I double click on this to edit, now, and this is as simple as it is, but I wanted to show you a bad example because this is just a sheet. There's some folds in it. Notice how there's different colors. So this is kind of a bad green screen. There's not good lighting on it, but it's still going to work kind of, sort of, okay? So I click on the dropper and I click on this, but this green here is different than that. So when I click, see how it keys out the green and shows me what's behind it, but it doesn't key this out right here. So like I said, that's kind of a bad example. So the gain is where you can mess with it, but you see how I'm losing a shirt also, okay? You know, so that's, you know, that's an example of a bad green screen. So the key to green screen is something like this, where you have it all one color, and you try to get, and that's hard to do, you know, perfect, but I just want to show you that then when you click on it and key it out, it's gone, okay? There's a little bit around him, if you can see that, and that's where the gain comes, and then you can mess with these down here. These kind of help with the edges, but that's, you know, that's how you deal with green screen, okay? The key is to get good lights on the screen itself, you know, and that's what you want, you know, on here is you want this lit up really well so you don't see the shadows and you don't want any wrinkles, okay? So that's the key to any type of green screen. To do that, that makes this a lot easier, okay? And it doesn't have to be green screen. Here I did it, this is my basement. I got a blue screen down there, which I won't get into, but it works the same way. Green is just a better color to key out, and you can key out any color you want, and that's fun for kids to kind of play with. The other thing that I want to show you is this here, fast, you know, slow motion, fast. So let me go to this clip here. If I double click on it, you know, you can add captions here. You can zoom in here. You know, if I want to zoom in, but then you're losing quality, you know, see how that's not a very good picture anymore. and I'm going to hit the trash here. That doesn't trash the clip. That trashes the changes that I made. So that you know, you can flip it horizontally, you can rotate it, you know, but I don't want to do that. This animation, this is great for the Ken Burns effect. I'm not going to show you that because we don't have a whole lot of time here, but if you want to Google that, that's something you can do. Color, brightness, contrast, here's your color keying, but then here's your fast motion, slow motion. You know, I can speed it up or slow it down. Now that's not going to do much for this clip, but let me show you an example of a place you can use it. I had a girl finish a project and she wanted to do like a how-to video, so I asked her to do a how-to of a how-to. So you've probably seen those videos where they write real fast on a chalk on a board like that, and that's all it is. This was her original clip and she just sped it up, you know, 8 times, 10 times, you know, and you can have a lot of fun with that. Instead of just putting titles in, you know, you can do stuff with that, okay? That's the advanced editing, I guess, that I wanted to show you, and there's so much more that you can do that I haven't showed, but I want to take a quick look at the admin, and if there's a lot of questions, you know, feel free to interrupt me and start doing that. I don't know if you're getting any questions in there. Otherwise, I'm going to keep going.
So there are some questions. So if you could go through this maybe about a minute or two, and then we'll switch over to ask questions, if that's okay with you.
Sure. Okay. You know, I did this mainly for teachers, but this is the setup of WeVideo. You know, the members, you know, have different, like, you know, to be able to add members. I guess if there's questions, I'm not going to go through this because your tech leads or tech admin will kind of have to do this. You can do it as a teacher too, but the videos up here show how to do that, you know, quite easily. You know, there's settings for, which I'm not going to go over that with teachers, but groups here is probably the only thing that you want to deal with. So as a teacher, if you're going to use this with your class and you've got, you know, first hour class, you know, I've got a third hour class, you can put all your students in there and work in that group, okay? You can add members to the group here. You can start a group project with your entire class, and then, you know, your first hour class will see it, but your other classes won't. And then as a teacher, the really nice part about, you know, being a teacher here, I can click on Josiah, and I can look at what he's done, you know, and that's the cool part about this, that you can get into all of their, as a lead, you know, teachers are, their roles are going to be leads, and I haven't gotten into the roles either, but you can see all your students' stuff, like this is what he uploaded, videos he created, and here are some projects. You can see he spent almost 4 hours in the editor for the month of May. He uploaded 24 files, and you can look at all that stuff, okay? You know, so I guess that's probably the main part about admin that teachers would need to know.
Well, thank you, Eric. Appreciate it. It's a great intro. There's a lot of information, but it looks like the software is really easy to use. So our first question comes from, well, we have a couple questions from Raymond. I think this came back from early on. It says, what do you mean by Zoom with feet?
Oh, Zoom with feet, most cameras, if you have a digital zoom on your camera, I would say never ever use it. You know, so when you're, if you want to take a close-up of something, zoom with your feet. In other words, get real close and get your camera that close. Yeah, I have a really nice video camera that has what's called optical zoom and an image stabilizer, so I can zoom with that, but if you have a, you know, if you're using your phone for a camera, or, you know, here, you need to get the camera real close, so don't use the digital zoom on it.
That makes sense, unless you're videotaping across the river or something. Don't go swimming.
Yeah.
Hopefully that makes sense. That does. The next question is, are there features you are using in the free or premium version of WeVideo? Is there a difference?
Yes, a difference. All the features that I showed you back into the editor, The premium features are all the ones that when I double clicked on it here, these are all premium features. You know, the transform, the green screen, this here, those are the premium features. I was under the impression most, like in Nevada, I think everybody has, I think the app, I was under the impression that you're all going to have the education account, which has the premium features.
Yeah, that's from my understanding, but you know, we can actually get more clarification on that.
Okay.
Yeah,
premium features are really cool. You know, that original project that I showed you, you know, taking that awesome video, just about everything I did in there could be done in the free version. Okay, all of that, you know, just but then you can only publish 5 minutes, I think it's 5 minutes per month that you can, you know, the videos. But so if you want to try something with your class and you don't have your account set up this year, you could try the free version just to learn how to do it. You could even do that activity, and then you'll be all set for next year. And, you know, and just the more kids have exposure, the more exposure you have to it, the better off you're going to be.
Yeah, yeah. So there was a question between the difference, the screencast. It says, does that mean is when we briefly saw you screencasting yourself versus
yes.
the camera?
Correct.
And the neat thing about these Chromebooks is that they're all going to have the camera that can face them, or they can turn it to face toward the front of the classroom. So these Chromebooks are going to be great tools to use this program.
Right. So screencasting, right, that's... Yep, that'll just record the screen where, no, actually, I take that back. That was the webcam. That was the webcam that I did. So you could see me, right, and then the screencast is just recording the actual screen. And that's another good thing for kids to do, you know, like a how-to video, how to do something. You know, and I've had kids do that, make how-to videos of, you know, somebody ask about green screen. So I've had students that knew how to do it, do a screencast of how to use the green screen, and then they put them on our website, and other kids could watch that.
Okay, so I think that was a confusion. She was asking what the screencast was again and how that worked.
Okay.
I think that might have been confusing of the difference between the webinar versus the screencast, what that looks like.
Okay. Did I answer that?
I might be a little confused, but maybe just review that quickly. We have about a minute.
The webcam will show, it's like you're taking pictures with a camera. The screencast, you're actually recording the screen on your computer, okay? So now, let's usually like the share entire screen. So now, I'm just going to record.
Well, that makes sense. So you're recording that picture, whatever you have on your actual laptop. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Let me see if there's any more questions. Looks like we have them answered. Raymond, I know you would love it if we had the FEDU premium account. I will double confirm that. I need to confirm that. Okay, well, I think I'm going to go into closing, and I'm going to switch presenters back to my screen. Thank you, Eric. I really appreciate it. You did a good job presenting today. You guys can still submit questions through the control panel. And we can get these questions as well back to you at the end, and also email as well. All right. Let me, hopefully everybody can see my screen. All right. So thanks, Eric, again, and thank you, everyone, for attending today's webinar, Introduction to WeVideo. It's a lot of information. If you have any other questions, contact me at the email that you see on the screen once you leave today's webinar. You will receive a survey on the presentation, and we would appreciate it if you would complete that and provide your feedback. This survey is very important to the Nevada 21 project. It is to help us evaluate these professional learning webinars. So please don't forget to visit our nr21.ctl.net website for news and information for Nevada 21 educators. We'd also like to invite you to our upcoming webinars in May, which you'll see the link there. You will also receive a follow-up email within 24 to 48 hours with the link to view the recording of today's webinar. I know I will be rewatching it over and over. On behalf of CTL and our presenters, thank you for joining us today, and have a great rest of your day. Bye.